Hello everyone, welcome back to this channel. This is Saroja. In previous videos, we already learned about prenatal stage and infancy period. Now, in this video, I am going to give a brief description of babyhood. Now, let us learn about babyhood, which is a stage after infancy. In this, we learn about brief description of babyhood and development that occurs at this stage, followed by physical hazards and psychological hazards in babyhood. Babyhood is a stage that follows infancy and extends between 2 weeks to 2 years. Babyhood is often referred as infancy. During babyhood, there is a gradual decrease in helplessness of a baby, and we also label baby as toddler during second year if once they achieved enough body control. Attributes of babyhood. Babyhood is a true foundation age because at this time many behavior patterns, many attitudes and emotional expressions are being established. Here it is important to know that the behavior learned at this age are early foundations that last throughout the lifespan. Age of rapid growth and change. Babies grow rapidly, both physically and psychologically. The growth is not confined to only appearance, but also in capacities of a baby. Age of decreasing dependency. At this age, babies learn to walk, sit, stand, and speak. So, independence of the baby starts here as they can easily move and communicate their needs. Beginning to socialization. Babyhood is beginning of socialization as babies show the desire to become a part of groups and starts protesting when they are left alone. They try to gain attention by others and develop strong emotional bonds with their mother. Beginning of sex role typing. From the moment of birth, boys are treated as boys and girls as girls. Toys are selected that are appropriate for each sex. Like for baby boys, toys of cars and trains are given, and for girls, Barbie dolls and teddies are given. Especially at this age, the girls are sex role typed by being permitted to cry and show other signs of female weakness, which these are disguised in baby boys. Babyhood is an appealing age. Babies look attractive at this age due to their big hands, thin limbs, tiny hands and feet. We feel them very attractive because of their helplessness and dependency. It is an age of beginning creativity. It is a fundamental age of a baby to develop interests and attitudes that will lay foundations for later creativity. Now, let's see how the babies start developing in multiple ways. Physical development. Here, we must know that by completion of babyhood, these developmental tasks will not come to an end. It's just a foundation for later stages. Weight. At the age of 4 months, the baby's weight has normally doubled. At 1 year, babies weigh on an average of 3 times as much as they did at birth. Increase in weight during babyhood comes mainly from an increase in fat tissues. Height. At 4 months, the baby measures between 23 and 24 inches, and at 1 year, it is between 28 and 30 inches, and at the age of 2 years, it is between 32 and 34 inches. Body builds at this age. 3 most common forms of body build are ectomorphic, endomorphic, and mesomorphic. Ectomorphic tends to be long and slender, and endomorphic tends to round and fat, and mesomorphic creates heavy, hard and rectangular. Changes in physical proportions like head growth slows down in babyhood, while trunk and limbs growth increases. Next, the development of teeth. The average baby has 4 to 6 temporary teeth by the age of 1 year, and 16 by the age of 2 years. Nervous system. At birth, brain weight is 1/8 of the baby's total weight. Gain in brain weight is greatest during the first 2 years of life. Bones. Most of the bones are developed and increased during babyhood. The soft spot on the skull has closed approximately by 18 months in 50% of babies and by 2 years in almost all babies. Muscles and fat. Muscle fibers are present at the time of birth but are undeveloped. They grow slowly during babyhood and that are weak. Fat tissues also develops rapidly due to high fat content of milk. Sense organ development. By the age of 3 months, the eye muscles are well enough coordinated to see things clearly. Hearing, touch, pressure, pain, and temperature are also present in well-developed forms at this stage. Next one is speech development. Speech is a tool for communication. So, to communicate with others, the babies must need to understand first what is said by others, and second, they need to respond. As they are not fully capable at this age to communicate completely, they use pre-speech forms to communicate. Pre-speech forms include crying, babbling, gestures, and emotional expressions. So now, what are the tasks involved in learning speech? There are three difficult tasks involved in learning speech, that is pronunciation, vocabulary building, and sentences. Babies learn how to pronounce words, building a vocabulary by associating meanings with words, and then combine these meaningful words to sentences that are understandable to others. Physiological functions. Babyhood is a period where physiological changes of eating, sleeping, and elimination patterns are established. During the age of 3 weeks, babies sleep for almost 8.5 hours, which it later increases to 10 hours at the age of 12 weeks. During the first 3 months, the decline in day sleep is balanced by increase in night sleep. Eating patterns. At the early months of baby, food is given in the form of liquids. Later, it is changed to semi-solid form. So, it is difficult for babies to adjust the changes in food as they are accustomed to food in liquid form. Patterns of elimination. Bowel control and bladder control also begins at this stage. Pattern of motor control. As a result of maturation of muscles, bones, nerve structures, and body proportions, babies are able to use their bodies in a coordinated manner. At this period, the changes occurs in head region, like giving eye coordination through vertical, horizontal, and circular eye movements, performing reflex responses and holding their heads erect. The changes at trunk region includes rolling over completely and sitting without support of others. Changes in arm and hand region includes picking up objects and working of thumb opposition to fingers. Changes in leg regions includes crawling, creeping, standing and walking without support. Emotional patterns. There are certain emotional patterns that are commonly found among babies. They are anger, fear, curiosity, joy, and affection. Anger. It occurs when we oppose a child in performing certain actions. Angry responses takes the form of screaming, kicking the legs, waving the arms, etc. Fear. Usually, fear arises when babies listen loud noises or seeing strange persons and objects and dark rooms. The response given by babies due to fear is crying, temporarily holding of breath, and avoiding from frightening stimulus. Curiosity. Anything new or unusual acts as a stimulus to curiosity. If at all the newness doesn't give rise to fear, the fear lost and it is replaced by curiosity. Joy. Joy is stimulated by physical well-being. They express joy by smiling and moving arms and legs. Affection. Anyone who plays with babies and takes care of them will be a stimulus for their affection. Affection is shown by hugging and kissing the loved object or person. Common play patterns of babyhood. First one is sensory motor play. This is the earliest form of play and consists of such things as kicking, bouncing, babbling, moving fingers and toes, and rolling. The next one is exploratory play. As hand and arm coordinations develop, babies begin to explore their bodies by pulling their hair, sucking their fingers, pulling their toys, and tearing any object within their reach. Next one is initiative play. During the second year, babies try to imitate the actions of those around them, such as reading a magazine, sweeping the floor, or writing with a pencil or crayon. Make-believe play. During the second year, most babies endow their toys with the qualities they find they have in real life. So, the dolls and trucks are treated by the baby as if they were real people or real trucks. Next one is games. They start playing with parents, grandparents, and older siblings at this period. The last one is amusements. Babies like to talk and read at this particular period. And most of the babies are fascinated by watching television and enjoy looking at pictures. Some of the concepts that develop in babyhood are space, weight, concept of self, social concepts, concepts of beauty, and concepts of comic. Concepts of space. Babies rarely reach for objects that are more than 20 inches away, indicating that they are able to estimate distance. The direction of their reach is usually correct. Concepts of weight. They are accurate during babyhood. Babies perceive a small object as light and large object as heavy. Concepts of self. Babies develop physical self-concepts by looking at themselves in mirrors. Before babyhood is completed, most babies know that they are either a boy or a girl. The next one is social concepts. By 8 months, the baby responds to the emotions of others revealed in their facial expressions. Concepts of beauty. Between the ages of 6 and 24 months, babies begin to respond to different colors. And concepts of comic. At this particular age, they derive enjoyment from dropping things that are handed to them, and they enjoy blowing bubbles in their milk and splashing their bath water. Hazards of babyhood. Physical hazards and psychological hazards. Physical hazards includes crib death, illnesses, accidents, malnutrition, and foundations of obesity. Crib death. Apparently, normal healthy babies are sometimes the victims of sudden and unexpected death, referred to in medical circles as crib death. Usually, crib death occurs after a long period of sleep. Next one is illnesses. While it is true that many deaths during the first few months of postnatal life are due to such illnesses as gastrointestinal or respiratory complications, the number of deaths due to serious illness then declines rapidly because most babies today are given vaccinations to immunize them against diseases. Next one is accidents. Although accidents are infrequent during the first year of life, as owing to the fact that babies are carefully protected in their cribs, but during the second year, it increases gradually because babies can move about more freely and are as well not protected. Next one is malnutrition. Malnutrition comes from inadequate food intake or from an unbalanced diet. The last one is foundations of obesity. Many parents do all they can to see that their babies are chubby. There is evidence that fat babies tend to have obesity problems as they grow older, while thin babies do not. Psychological hazards. Speech hazard. Delayed speech is serious in babyhood because at this age the foundations are being laid for the development of the tools of communication. Hazards in motor development. When motor development is delayed, babies will be at great disadvantage to begin play with their age mates. Social hazards. The major social hazard of babyhood is lack of opportunity and motivation in learning to become social. This encourages the prolongation of egocentrism, which is characteristic of all babies and leads to the development of introversion. Last one is play hazards. The major psychological hazard is that the baby may come to rely too much on the toys themselves for amusement, instead of learning to play in ways that involve interaction with others. This is the overview of fine motor skills and gross motor skills of babies up to 24 months. Thank you. Stay tuned to get more information about further developmental stages.